Good morning students, how are you? I think all of you fine and I hope you are all, your parents and you are all fine. This is the critical situation, that's why you have to take care of yourself and also take care of your parents. My name is Arunakumari Perala, KGPV Narasimhapeta, Guntur District, Physical Science CRT. Children, come to the point. Already in the previous class, we learned about the acids, base and salts, about the properties of the acids, base and salts. I think you are all reading that topic and you are all very thoroughly in that topic. And also we learned about the acids reactions and base reactions. These are all we learned in the previous class. Today, we learn about the more about acids, base and salts. Already in the previous class we do an activity. In that activity we recall that activity once again. We are taking a beaker two electrodes. These two electrodes connect with AC plug and bulb. With this we are taking dilute hydrochloric acid in the beaker. These are the electrodes. We are taking a beaker and fill with some dilute hydrochloric acid. Dilute hydrochloric acid, and we are arranged two electrodes. With the two electrodes connected with a AC plug and also bulb. This bulb glows. Already in the previous class, we learned this activity, about this activity. This activity means the acid conducts electricity. What is this activity means? The acid conducts electricity. That means the electricity flows through the acids. That's why here the bulb is glow. Why the bulb glows here? The acids conduct electricity. The electricity passes through these connections and the bulb glows. In the same way, I am taking another beaker. And also, this is also connected with AC plug. And also I am taking bulb here also, but here I am taking HCl solution. Here also I am taking acid solution, but this is acetic acid. What is this? Acetic acid. What is this one? Acetic acid. So here I am taking HCl, here I am taking acetic acid. So this is the acid and this is also acid. These two are acids. The bulb grows in this activity also, in this activity also. The bulb grows here also. But here the bulb grows very bright. Here the bulb grows very bright. But here the bulb grows some dim. Here the bulb grows very bright. But here the bulb grows some bright. What is the reason behind this? This is acid. Here the acid is conductivity, the acid, the bulk glows. Here also, this is also acid. Here the bulk glows. These two are the acids. Here these two, in these two activities, the bulk glows. But here the bulk glow very bright and here the bulk glow dim. What is the reason behind this? What is the reason? The reason behind this, here in the HCl solution, the H3O plus ions more in HCO solution. In the acetic acid solution, HCO plus ions less. That means lower compared with the HCl solution. In the acetic acid, lower HCO plus ions. In the HCl solution, more HCO plus ions. That's why the more HCO ions cause the light glows brightly. Lower HCO plus cause the bulb glows dim. That is the reason here. That means this is depends upon the strength of the acids. strength of the ear, the bulb grows depends upon the strength of the acid. Which is the depend upon? Strength of the acid. Here the more strength, here the less strength. That's why in the more strength, the bulb grows very bright. That means more HCO plus ions here. Here, less strength. That means here, the acetic acid have lower HCO plus ions. That's why this is the reason for the bulk grows in the different for the different activities. So universal indicator is the indicator is used to find the concentration. Here more means more concentration, less means less concentration. Universal indicator is used to find out the concentration of the given solution. Concentration of the given solution. We have one universal indicator, that is pH scale. So pH scale is the scale that measures to hydrogen ion concentration in the given solution. For example, if you take one solution, any solution, to what is the pH of the solution, to find out the solution, how many, what is the concentration of the hydrogen ions in the solution, that is the pH of that solution. Here, solution name of the solution is here, and color, which color we got here? Red color. value. What is the value? pH value. pH value. What is the pH value? Huh? We get red color. So red color for the red color. pH 3. The hydrochloric acid pH 3. So which nature of the substance? Acid. Which is some? We got from 0 to 6. That nature is acidic nature. Next one, we are taking sodium bicarbonate. I am taking sodium bicarbonate solution. With the sodium bicarbonate, I prepare solution. Sodium bicarbonate solution. See which color? Green. Which color, ma? Green. So sodium bicarbonate. Green color I got. So the pH value for the green color is, see here. Here the values in the pH indicator also from 0 to 7, 8 to 14. So green is 9. So basic in nature. Next I am taking sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide solution. Sodium hydroxide solution. I find out the pH of the sodium hydroxide solution. I find out the pH of the sodium hydroxide solution. See the color. I am preparing the sodium hydroxide solution with the help of the sodium hydroxide plates. So we can make the solutions with the help of the water. So see, this is blue color. Blue in color. See ma, this is blue in color. So we got the blue color. What is the blue color? See what blue color? The pH of the sodium hydroxide 14 is in the basic nature. Next one, lemon juice. I am taking lemon juice. See the color of the lemon juice. See ma? See here. Red color. Red value to lemon juice. Same lemon juice. Red color. And also I am checking the. Like that all we can do that. Tomato juice. We got the orange color. Tap water. See here we got the. This tap water contains the pH from 6 to 8. Neutral solutions. Tap depends upon the pH. Some tap has some pH, some has some pH. Depends upon the soil. The water depends upon the pH, depends upon that. So the pH of the tap water from 6 to 8. So see all of the colors. See ma. So color of that, so depends upon the color we can find out the pH of that solution. So these are the different colors for the different solutions. We got the different colors for the pH paper, different color for the different. Here we see different colors for the different solutions. So depends upon the color we can find out the pH of that solution. Once again, I explain about the pH. Ma, the pH scale, the scale that measures the pH of the given solution. The scale that measures the pH of the given solution. If 0 to 6, 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Here from 0 to 6, acidic nature, acidic nature and 8 to 14 basic in nature and 7 neutral. Here from 0 to 6 acidic nature and 8 to 14 basic nature, 7 is the neutral solution. So pH, that is about the pH mark to find out the strength of the given solution. So now we can learn about the pH change in our daily life. Now we can learn about the pH in our so much important in our daily life for the pH. So pH in our daily life.
Stomach problems.
produced in our digestive system. That's why we have to maintain good food habits. And also to reduce the problem, already you are seeing your home, your mother or father, anyone, mother and your father facing this type of problems. What they are taking? They are taking Eno, Geracil like that. These are the antacids. That means more acid produced in our summer with the help of these antacids. That the antacids contains the base. So this base produced in our stomach acid, these two are combined neutral. Then our problem reduced by the neutral solutions. That's why our parents are, we are also taking the like antacids. The antacids take the irritation problem in the stomach reduced. This is the pH in our digestive system and also the pH of the soil. So we are saying we are planting for the plants for the, we are using soil. Planting for the purpose of the planting, we are using the soil. Some plants have some pH, some peats have some pH. Depending on the pH, we are using the crop. So depending on the pH, the more acidic nature, with the help of the basic one, they are neutral in the soil. With the help of the, with the more basic nature in the soil, with the help of the acid, acidic nature substances, they are neutral in the soil. Then only which pH range is essential for the growth of the plants, the farmers or the scientists use that pH of the, they are testing the, they are testing the soil in the labs. What is the pH of the soil and what is the range of the, to grow the plants very good health? What is the range of the plant? What is the range of the pH for the plant? They are testing. So pH of the soil also depends upon the growth of the plant and crop. So pantanu kuda amma pH depend ayi untadamma. Aa panta veyadaniki etuvanti pH unte aa panta baaga pandutundi. Aa nelaki etuvanti pH unte aa panta baaga pandutundi anedi depend ayyi. Okavela pH daniki enta avasaramo dani taggattuga aa nelalo etuvanti erulu gaani alaga vesi dani pH range ni batti aa panta ni enchukodam jarigindamma. This is the about the pH in our daily life. So as the plants and animals, it is sensitive to, is the pH changes through the decay, and also the most one is now the pH is depends upon our digestive system also. So some pH range is in our soil also. So these are the, this is the pH in our daily life. So very important pH in our daily life also. Sodium hydroxide and chlorine hydroxide. decomposes and produces these products. With the help of this product, we can manufacture some, we can produce some products like the bleaching powder, baking soda and washing soda. Like that, we can produce with the help of this brain solution or salt solution. Electrolysis of the brain solution, we can manufacture these products. Students, I want to introduce one thing about the salt. In the independence, our Mahatma Gandhi, in the independence time, Mahatma Gandhi, we didn't have Uppu Satyagraha money. So, this salt take a major role in the independence. Gandhi garu tax katta vishayamlo satyagrahame chesaru anamata. So, salt ki anta pravamukyata undi mana independence time nunchi. So, manam kuda salt enti em telliyam kadamma. Alage salt nunchi manaki salt solution nunchi ee products manam tayaru chesukuntam. Brain solution, decomposes sodium hydroxide, chlorine and hydrogen. With the help of, we can prepare bleaching powder with the chloroalkyl process. This process is called chloroalkali process. With the help of this process, we can prepare, we can manufacture the bleaching powder. So, calcium hydroxide combined with chlorine gas, we can produce bleaching powder. This is bleaching powder. You can prepare the, you can produce the bleaching powder. So, what is the use of the bleaching powder? You know the bleaching powder? Now, uses of the, now we can learn about the uses of the bleaching powder. The first one is carbon and lead in the textile industry. So, this bleaching powder used in the industry of the carbon and textile to color the agent of the some cloth like the wood, like the. We can use the, it is used in the cotton and linen industry, textile industry also, we can use this bleaching powder. And also, used as an oxidizing agent in the many chemical industries. We are using this bleaching powder like oxidizing agent in some chemical industries. In the industries, we are using this bleaching powder also, ma. So, in the textile industry and also in the chemical industries. So, next one, this one we all know about this one. For the disinfecting the drinking water, some small viruses are there in the drinking water to disinfect the, used for the disinfecting drinking water to make it free of germs. If the germs are present in the drinking water, with the help of the bleaching powder, we can disinfecting. Disinfecting means we can disinfect that water to free the germs from the drinking water. So this is the third use of the bleaching powder. Bleaching powder. The next one is used as reagent in the preparation of chloroform. So, in the preparation, while we are preparing the chloroform, we are using this bleaching powder as a reagent. Understand, ma? While preparing the chloroform, we are using this bleaching powder as reagent. These are the use of the bleaching powder. Very important, ma. All of you note down in your notebook. The first one is, we are using this bleaching powder in the cotton and linen textile industry. And the next one is oxidizing agent in chemical factories and chemical industries. And disinfecting the drinking water to free up the germs in the water. The next one, reagent in the preparation of the chloroform of the bleaching powder in our daily life. First, we learn about the uses of the bleaching powder and preparation of the bleaching powder. And next one is baking soda. Sodium carbonate solution and water, carbon dioxide. Therefore, this we can produce sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate means baking soda. Sodium hydrogen carbonate. The name of the sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate. We can produce the in the chloroalkyl process, with the help of the chloroalkyl process. We can use that products, we can produce sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate, take the sodium bicarbonate, if we heat the sodium bicarbonate, it decomposes into sodium carbonate, water and the carbon dioxide. So, like this we can use the baking soda. Now we can learn about the use of the baking soda. So, this baking soda is used to prepare the baking powder also. This baking soda used to prepare the baking powder. Baking powder is mixture of baking soda and mild acid, tartaric acid, like the tartaric acid. cooking food. To prepare, to produce the baking powder, we are using the baking soda and mild edible oil. The next use is, it is also used as ingredients in antacids. It is also prepared already in the previous pH in our digestive system. We are using antacids to neutralize our stomach. In the antacids, to prepare of the antacids, we are using the using this as one ingredient. This baking soda, we are using one ingredient in preparation of the antacids. The next use is, it is also used as soda in the fire extinguishers. That means fire accidents happen in the surroundings. We are using this baking soda prepared to produce the fire extinguish. We are using this baking soda also. Next, it is acts as a mild antiseptic. So we are using this like antiseptic also. These are the uses of the baking soda. These are also very important. Previous we have learned about the bleaching powder, and this is about the baking soda. The next one is washing soda. The next one is washing soda. We have learned about the washing soda. The third one is washing soda. So, next washing soda. The next one is washing soda. Soda bicarbonate combined with the molecules of water become washing soda. Here, the use of the washing soda, we are preparing the we are using for the glass industry, soap industry, and paper industry. The washing soda, we are using this washing soda in the glass, soap, and paper industry. The next one is, it is used in the manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax. In the preparation of manufacturing of the borax also, we can use this washing soda. First one is, the paper, glass, soap, and paper industries. For the manufacturing of the glass, soap, and paper, we are using the washing soda in the industries. And the second one is manufacturing of the sodium compounds such as borax. In the preparation of the manufacturing of the borax, we are using this washing soda. The next one is cleaning agent for the domestic purpose. So we are using this as the cleaning agent. Like the cleaning agent in the domestic purpose, in the household domestic purpose, we are using this washing soda. The next one is, it is used for the removing the permanent hardness of the water. And also, we are using this washing soda to remove the permanent hardness. To remove the hardness of the water, we are using this washing soda. These are the uses of the washing soda. The first one is industries of the glass, soap, and paper. The second one is, it is used in the manufacturing of the sodium carbonate compounds like the borax. And the third one is, it is used in the cleaning agent like washing soda in our domestic purposes. The last one is, it is used for the removing hardness of the water. To remove the hardness of the water, we are using this washing soda. These are the uses of the washing soda. We learned about the bleaching powder and their uses, and baking soda and their uses. The third one is washing soda and their uses. These are the three products we are using in our daily life. These are the very important ones. We note all these uses and read this and write to without seeing the book and learn the formulas of this 4-1. Bleaching powder formula and baking soda and washing soda formula. This is all you have to learn. This is very important. Read the textbook and note down the formulas and practice the formulas. That is very useful in writing the half-mark questions also. These are the very important formulas. So, uses also very important for the exams. Now, you can learn about the uses of these three items. Now, here, sodium carbonate solvent part. Is it dry? Is it wet? My tadiga untada idi podiga untada idi 10 water molecules unni ante tadiga untada so no for that why so crystallization so here some crystals are there what in the crystallization form here what in the crystallization form so reviewing this crystallization form we can do one activity reviewing of crystals in the given substances I am taking copper sulfate crystals I am taking copper sulfate see ma these are the copper sulfate crystals I am taking copper sulfate crystal hydrated copper sulfate crystal so copper here 5 water molecules means this is in the dehydrated form dry hydrated form these are in the form of crystals is the crystal is the water in the form of crystal is the why is the water present in this crystal or not for that one we are doing one activity I am taking copper sulfate crystals in the test tube I am taking copper sulfate crystal what is present in the crystal in the dihydrated form to removing this water in the crystals we are doing this activity removing of crystallization so I am removing the water in the crystals and taking test tube and pour some copper sulfate crystal in the test tube with the help of the stand spirit lamp this is also important activity ma write an activity to remove the crystals in the given substance given chemical compound See all of you the color changes here the crystals color changes here the crystal color changes that means the crystal removing the water from the crystals and see the water bubbles forms on the test tube test tube the water present in the crystals come become vapors and on the test tube walls see the vapors of the water on the test tube walls all of you look at the water in the test tube walls see my water bubbles on the test tube walls and also the color is also changed it turns to white color the copper sulfate blue color it turns to white color and the presence of the water becomes vapor and forms on the bubbles on the walls of the test tube See, are you see the bubbles of the water? Are you see bubbles of the water? So the color also changes. See, ma, are you here? The color also changes. The copper sulfate blue color changing to white color. Are you look at the color? The copper sulfate blue color turning to white color. Water bubbles on the test tube walls. That means the water in the present in the crystals become vapors, and the vapors become forms on the bubbles on the water cycle. That means the crystals present water in the hydrated form. That means like that we can remove the water. Now we can add some water. Once again the color now before the color is white now the color is turns to blue now the color turns to blue that means in the presence of the water the color is blue in presence of the water becomes vapor the color turns to white that means now what we have to do with this activity with in the copper sulfate crystals, they are removing the water from the copper sulfate crystal. This activity name is removing of crystallization. Removing of crystallization. That means the water present in this crystalline dihydrated form. So, with this help of the activity, we can find water is in the crystals also. So, this is the crystallization of the water. Crystallization of the removing of the crystallization. That means this is the 10H2O, 5H2O like that. Dehydrated forms of the crystals. The water present in the crystalline hydrated forms. If we heat this crystal, the water becomes like wrapper. Like this. If we add some water to this, the color becomes same. Before the heating that one, a color same again. So, this is about the removing of the crystallization. Next one is crystallization of removing of copper sulfate crystals, removing the water from the copper sulfate crystals. Now, the next one is crystallization forming the glass block pans. If we heat the gypsum, it divided into cast of calories and water. If we add the one and a half molecule of the water to the cast of calories, it becomes gypsum. So here the gypsum and cast of calories changes of gypsum and cast of calories depends upon the water molecule combination. In the cast of calories, half water molecule is there. If we add one and a half water molecule to the cast of calories, it becomes gypsum. In the gypsum, two water molecules. In the plaster of Paris, half water molecule. This is about the plaster of Paris. You know the plaster of Paris to making the ideal figures. To prepare some articles, we are using this plaster of Paris. So, this is about the plaster of Paris and crystallization. And gypsum. Students, up to now we learn about the pH values and pH in our daily life, and also about the salts and salt family and the chloro-alkali process. With the help of the chloro-alkali process, we have manufactured some daily life nutrients like washing soda, bleaching powder, baking soda like that. And also next we are learn about the crystallization of the water. So removing of the crystallization. So these are all learn great classes. All of you listen carefully. Ma, you have to do one work. You take text book and read all this one and note down in the notebook. No need any guide and anyone. You have to follow the textbook. Take the textbook and read each topic once again and note down the formulas and note down the images and note down the chemical equations. This is very useful. Practice one and more times. This is very useful for the all things, for the lab activity and for the half mark question and 2 marks question, for the everything. Very important for us. Now, I will give a small homework to you and write the homework and read the write the homework. The first one is homework. What is the formula of bleaching powder? What is the formula of bleaching powder? And write the uses of bleaching powder. These are the two homeworks. Do all of you these two homeworks. and read this lesson thoroughly from top to bottom, from first to last one. All of you read the textbook and follow the and write the notes, note down the all formulas and everything. Thank you for watching.